Hello, my name's Jeff. I'm with Peter Lynn here. Today we're going to talk a little bit about Pika. Peter, what does the future of filmmaking look like with all this new AI tech?
So hopefully in the future, you can write your script, feed that to a generative AI, and it'll spit out a movie for you.
And is that possible today?
So there's a couple of ones. Pika is one that's showing some pretty cool results. So we'll include links in the description. Stable Diffusion is working on adding that. Midjourney is also adding features for that. And there's a couple other ones that are also working on movie generation from prompts.
Now we'll get into some of the features that Pika talks about in their video. Or in the analysis that we'll demonstrate. But one of the things that was interesting is that in a recent competition, that particular group got fifth place or something. And I think they were using older methods. And since then, they've pivoted a little bit. Do you have an insight into kind of what they did that was different based on what everyone else is doing?
Not really. They're still pretty kind of, they're still in a kind of a quiet mode. But I think that the story that's up on YouTube and in the space is the two founders competed in a competition. They didn't like the existing tools. And so they decided, hey, we're going to build our own tools.
And who are these founders?
Two former ML people from, I think, Meta or Google or something like that. I don't know exactly. Yeah.
Great. And then some of the features that I saw in there are really neat. First of all, you could just give it a verbal prompt and it would produce, you know, a video image. You could also feed it an image and it could make that image come to life. And one of the examples was, I think it was The Last Supper. And all of a sudden that particular image, you know, the disciples and Jesus were moving. These seem pretty new, and could, you know, make for some incredibly creative opportunities for people in the future, don't you think?
Yeah, like, you know, today, if you wanted to make a movie, you would write the script, you'll send it into one of the studios, somebody or people will read it. If it gets selected, it'll be greenlit. Go to some executive, they'll call you in, they'll make a deal. It gets, they buy the rights for a certain number of years, and then it may or may not become a movie, or it might just die. In the future, hopefully, if someone is a good writer, they can write their script, they can use one of these tools to generate characters. And let's say someone wants to make a rom-com, they go, well, someone that looks, give me an actress that looks like a cross between Meg Ryan and some other famous actress, Jennifer Lawrence, right? You could go through multiple iterations, find it, and then you could then feed that to this movie generation, say, now here's the script starring this fictional hybrid character that was made up with the hybrid fictional male lead that maybe you want Tom Hanks and Tom Cruise mismatched.
Yeah, I mean, the possibilities are pretty much endless. And I saw too that with this particular tool with Pika, you could use actual video and kind of edit it, right? So you could put a different outfit on someone.
Yeah, it's called in-painting.
In-painting, okay.
Yeah, the tricky bits will be this. Let's say someone wants to write an action film. Now, if you say, give me an action film with three people fighting, right, it's going to give you something garbage.
Yeah.
But the cost of doing motion capture is getting really cheap now. So now you could go to your local karate studio or taekwondo studio or whatever studio is close to you, find a few people and say, hey, could you choreograph a fight for me? We'll mocap it in the mocap studio. You can then take that, take your AI generated characters, and then say, now take the mocap, take these three characters, and render it.
I mean, that takes, you know, some of the CGI stuff and makes it almost irrelevant.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. So, like, you know, basic stuff you can do, but if you wanted to do, like, John Wick 4, where it's really, like, in John Wick 4, there's that fight scene where it's shot from above. Like, that scene is just amazing.
Yeah.
The stunt performers and Keanu going from room to room.
Yeah.
Like, you wouldn't be able to do that with just mocap. Like, you need the actual environment. You need the actual actors and stunt performers really doing it, you know, like, actually making contact.
Yeah.
Actually jumping over stuff, having explosives go off, and then some CGI stuff. So that, like, you couldn't get something like John Wick 4, but not every movie needs a John Wick 4.
Right. Well, I mean, I think the first invasion will probably be all these cartoons, Pixar's, animes that are out there, right? With just a human voiceover. Once you've got the scenes, lay them all out, get some voice actors, and you've got yourself a cartoon.
Yep.
Well, this is exciting. It'll be fun to watch this, and we will include some parts of the video and the link to the analysis or the kind of the press release almost of Pika's current update and what they've done and the new release. The nice thing about Pika is it's currently free, and it's intended to stay free for a while. So it's something that we can all kind of play with. Peter, thanks for the lesson here, and we'll try to capture more of these on future videos. Take care, everybody.